children. If you ask them which of them was my first baby, they'll say none of us. Uncle Corny was her first baby. I've known my brother as long as I've known myself. He was the first love of my life. When we were little, I protected him. Suddenly, when he turned 12, he was my bodyguard. He even thought it was his responsibility to carry a chip on his shoulder on my behalf because I was born with one hand. As he matured, he took pride in simply adoring me instead of being angry for me. My best friend, first love, first baby, my introduction to the soulmate concept, that was my brother. Was is a very unnatural verb in reference to someone so real to me. It feels like a betrayal to refer to him in the past tense. I still wait to wake up one day to find that it was all a dream. Maybe he wasn't John Doe and Shock Trauma. Maybe he wasn't the 21st murder on the 22nd day of the year in 2007. Not only is this murder unrealistic, it's the one thing I had convinced myself that I could not survive. I often said things like, if I ever lose my brother, I would be quiet for the rest of my life. What else would there be to say? Or they better make the hole big enough to bury us both. I do have two brothers left, and that doesn't matter. The truth is, there was only one David Thomas. And I don't have any more of those left. So it's unfair that he was murdered and the world just kept going on like nothing happened. When he was killed, my other brothers, my cousins and I, we wanted to find the person who did it. No doubt we could think of ways to get justice. At first, I couldn't wait for the police to find the guy so I could spit in his face. My male family members certainly had more violent plans for the culprit. Then, we saw Corny's body. Rage turned into confusion. Confusion erupted into devastation. Devastation morphed into regretful acceptance. Acceptance birthed a sad wisdom. Wisdom is amazingly stubborn. Once you have it, you can't pretend that you don't. It won't let you. A dead body is a dead body. All the justice in the world won't bring it back to life. If I spit my mouth dry at the murderer, if my family beat the life out of him, if a jury executed him, I would never wake up to find my brother protecting me again. There would just be one more dead body. There's nothing about one more dead body that brings me peace. I can't find anything that feels just about another family looking at a dead body. Nobody wants to die in vain. Seeing the body of my first love, I realized that his death would mean nothing if justice meant killing again. I want life in return for my brother's death. He is worth forgiveness in return for violence. He is worth healing in return for devastation. It's not that he was worth life. All the rage and pain make him a was. But when talking of true justice for him, he still is. He exists in the beauty of mercy, not the destruction of execution. All of our humanness exists in forgiveness in the face of violence. It's only reflex that tells us that death warrants more death. But it's wisdom that reminds us that a person who is murdered deserves for those seeking justice to be at their noblest. The person deserves their death to bring out the best in those of us still alive. We can't possibly be at our best when justice looks like one more dead body. Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. This is one of America's basic ideas. It speaks of mercy and promises second chances. It boasts that being American means being strong enough to give our best to those who are at their worst. How then can it be American to murder the wretched refuse bred on If that's the modern American idea, then what are we really saying? That we are all out of ideas, fresh out of hope? So disillusioned by our own society that all we can do is wash our hands of the refuse and pile their bodies in the corner? I think we're stronger than that. I know there's much work to be done to end violence in this country, and it's too late for that work to save my brother. But it's never too late to recognize which solutions are noble and humane. There's still time to decide that being American means handling out justice in wisdom, not in